How's it going, guys? Back again for Vlog 94, Resolutions to Reality. Got my co-host, Lacey Shade, aka Georgia.
Georgia!
Here with me today. Still April the 8th. I don't think so. Still April the 8th. It is 2:21 a.m. So we're doing a late night call. I'm trying to catch up on not to run anything. Yeah, try on the car. Getting close to the edge.
Oh, shit.
Do you feel like moving out?
I feel like I'm not moving.
Okay. But, yeah, so. Going to. This is my third video for the night. Sorry, I'm gonna lose that a little bit. Really just catching myself back up from, this is actually for Friday. No, this is for Monday, April the 4th. So what I did on Monday I went to work, Tuesday I went to work, I think I might have got my first credit card on Monday, not exactly sure, but I did tell you guys that I got me some new credit cards, just trying to build my credit up. got me some new credit cards. Trying to build the credit. I've actually been taking some shots of Cuervo tonight, so feeling okay. Feeling a little off work shenanigans. Thursday. I figured that would help the videos go by quicker and giving us more to talk about, but apparently it didn't work out the way I planned it because it's been like drinking at a daycare, you know. It's just attending to children, it's tipsy. Not a big deal, not nothing I'm not familiar with. I mean, I don't really do this very often, but just trying to help get things situated so that we can have some adult time. But, you know, kids wake up in the middle of the night, especially kids that typically sleep with you and you're not in the bed, they tend to not stay sleeping. But, no big deal. Not a big deal. Just the way it is right now for us. So, for April the 4th, it was a Monday, so I mean, nothing like extravagant. I went to work. I can't really think of anything particular besides, you know, maybe not before. I think on the 4th I got Colin's birthday shoes arrived in the mail. So that was one thing. Yeah, other than that, you know, it was just a typical day, you know, it's another day in the neighborhood. Thinking a lot about Sierra, getting that project underway. Put a lot more focus into trying to keep myself emotionally stable and trying to not let my emotions get the best of me. That's been working out pretty well. Have though, on the other hand, been taking my medication more than I would like to be, mainly because I feel like once I get started taking it, it's like a very slippery slope of me wanting to abuse it or overuse it,
which I don't want to do.
Also, I don't like the idea of thinking that medication is necessary for me. I don't like the idea of thinking that something is actually wrong with me to the point that I need medical help. But in all honesty, I think that is the case. But it has helped me tremendously with work as far as like focusing and remaining energetic. Something else I've been thinking a lot about lately is working out. It does make me want to get to the gym more. And get back to working out. Started out doing. I haven't been to the gym in over a month, which is very disappointing, seeing how I don't really have the disposable income to be able to afford to pay for a membership that I'm not using. But at the end of the day, I have to take baby steps and work my way up to where I want to get to. I've been watching like these bodybuilding documentaries and seeing people bodybuild on Instagram, and it's kind of making me like jealous, interested in getting back into that, not that lifestyle, because I've never been a bodybuilder, but interested in wanting to take care of myself to that extent. But only time will tell. I have to really get into a position where I can dedicate my time to that as a hobby. I'm not saying that I can't, because I can. It's just the act of wanting to get up and crack an ass in the morning to go do it, and to continuously do that every day, that really holds me back the most. It's not necessarily holding me back, it's me being, you know, opposed to the idea that causes the most conflict, you know, basically meaning I'm just lazy. But, trying to overcome that, my medication definitely helps me to overcome that, but it also leads me to not rest enough to the point that I overexert myself and crash very hard. But I do need to exercise in order to keep my blood pressure down, because my medication does raise my blood pressure, which is not good at all. Something else has been on my mind lately that I've been kind of not really struggling with, which just thinking on harder is that place I've started smoking again, and I have not, but she's been staying here with me for the past few days, almost a week, and I actually bought her some cigarettes so that she was comfortable. And now I'm in a place where I'm struggling more than I was in the beginning to stick to my guns of resistance. I don't know if it's because, you know, she's so close and the opportunity is right in front of me, or if it's just because now I've become more weak-minded because of her presence or my desire for her to be present. But I've kept my word, and I have not indulged. I haven't allowed myself to succumb to those urges. Even after I bought the cigarettes myself and stood outside tonight, and she smoked two right in front of me, and I was just like, you know, it's not that big a deal. I think another reason why it's like prominent in like the forefront of my thoughts is because I'm on my medication, which, like I said before, makes it really difficult to not want to, because it's like when I'm on it, I just kind of just like slows down the fast pace, but so far so good. I haven't went back on that resolution, which I'm proud of. I'm not disappointed in her for doing that. I understand, you know, that was kind of one of my things that I wanted to correct. Doesn't mean it's everybody's, and I don't judge her for that. You know, I'm only holding myself to a standard. I'm not holding anybody else. But it definitely has shown me, you know, that I have to be strong in different situations, even when it's like super close to home, or like really difficult. But like I said, so far so good, and I'm just gonna keep my focus where it's been. I'm just telling you about smoking. Saying that it makes it harder because, like, when we're outside earlier, I wanted to smoke, and like, I can't tell the difference of whether it's because I want to smoke because it's something to do with you, or if I want to smoke because it's not something that I want for myself, because it's just like an urge. But something else I was thinking about at work that crossed my mind was that, you know, maybe the reason why it's been so hard for me to quit in the past and even now, because even though I do figure out how to turn myself off from it. I don't figure out how to separate myself from people that do that are close to me. And it's kind of like...
I'll try and figure it out.
I mean, but regardless, it's just like, you know... It's like the same old person with other songs I don't feel. And around four broke people, one will probably be the fifth. It's like, it just makes it harder when you hang around. I think about it like this, not just you, but the majority of my friends that I have, like, they may not smoke cigarettes, but they smoke in general. It's like,
it's a hard habit to
break. It is.
And I was around a hospital sometimes until literally 2 weeks ago, and I ended up breaking.
Yeah, it is rough. Like, it is hard to...
Disappointed in myself.
I don't think you should be disappointed. I think you should just try again when you're ready. That's all it takes. I mean, I've... Numerous times. It just feels like this time I'm just like, I don't know, I'm just like, it feels like I'm kind of like, I don't want to say wore out, but I'm just like, I know what I'm
missing.
I just know what I'm missing and I don't miss it. Like, you know, sometimes you think, oh man, I'm missing out on all the fun, and then it's like, you think that one time, and it's like, I wasn't missing out on shit, I just learned my striving. Because you know what it's like, you know exactly what, you know everything about it. I've literally done it so many times, I'm 30 years old, it's like, there's nothing that's gonna change. But it's like, the addiction is chasing a dragon, it's like,
it's too much of a
handle
now, so.
I think that too, but I think like more than that, the addiction is more strongly connected to the fact that it's like a very simple, bland, like plain buzz. Like the lightheadedness, or like the way it feels like your throat is opening up more when you first hit it. I think that's what a lot of people are drawn into. That's what I felt the first time. I can remember like yesterday, the first time I smoked a cigarette, it felt like the back of my throat was just like, I could feel it expanding further, like bigger. And it's like when you inhale, the back of my throat was just like, it's like, and it was just like, every time I smoked, I would want that. Like, every time I would hit a cigarette, I would just feel like, and then after I did it for so many years, it was like, don't feel shit and don't even care to try to lose. But like I said, I've still been holding on strong, and that means a lot to me because, you know, like I said in the beginning of this whole series, I don't keep any resolutions to myself at all. I want to keep, like, if I go until December 31st of 2022, and on January the 1st, I just smoked ice cream. That's way better than giving up in the middle of the year, or not making it the whole year, but I definitely want to make it this whole year.
Because I've never made it a year.
Since I started smoking, I made it 6 months, made it 3 months, made it all these little months. I haven't made it either. And that's my goal. Like, indulging now is like, you know, I don't want to feel controlled by an addiction. I want to feel like I'm in control. And that means a lot to me right now, especially with where my life is headed. I think a lot of the reason why my life has taken like an uptick is because I've convinced myself that I regained my self-control and my self-worth. I don't think indulging in that is like, I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm drinking Jose right now, but this isn't something that, A, I feel like I have a huge addiction to, like, I could really do without this. I don't really indulge on this on a regular basis. It's really just on the weekends and after work, and it's not something that I think about all day when I'm watching what you It's like I don't have the attachment to this that I had to. Like, cigarettes was something that I had to do like all day, every day, everywhere I went. And that's something I don't like, is the way it feels like it controls me. But I didn't make like a resolution to really put drinking away. Drinking isn't illegal. I mean, cigarettes aren't illegal, but it's just like the way it makes me feel. And like, the strength, like the actual strength of the addiction that you can feel is what really bothers me about smoking. But I will say that, you know, like I said, drinking and taking my medication does spike my interest in indulging in smoking. So that's another reason why I try to lean away from taking my medication as prescribed, and I try to lean away from drinking because it just leads to other things, and it makes you kind of weak-minded to where you kind of talk yourself into it being okay. I don't like to feel like that. I like to feel in control.
There's whispers of feeling in control.
Are you making fun of my whispers?
Yeah, I'm sure.
I don't see him. Oh, you're talking about. I think you're just trying to, I think you're trying to, make a diversion so I don't talk about smoking.
Yeah. Is this how you're going on? On my face from forever ago, still there.
Just left it. Yeah.
And then just left it.
He's feeling it, but he didn't tell you to change the suit. He thought you were thinking I washed him.
Oh. But then I wash the sheets every night.
Oh, so there's still going to be right now?
Mm-hmm.
Great.
Yeah, the first day.
Yeah, it's only you.
Bathroom's free now.
Bathroom's free.
Yeah, you feed in the shower? No, the bathroom's free.
Where do you get this? Which supplies to?
Hopefully.
I wouldn't waste my Google minutes.
You don't know no better than me.
There's no animals down here either, so you're good.
No, I'm not good. Seems to think you're good. Welcome to Nats. I stayed down here for a long time last winter, so I'm going to be back soon.
No
grapes. Kind of jewels. No grapes.
Yeah,
I was
sold.
Probably. You got a lazy body.
I got a lazy body.
You guys are opposite.
I think mine is this one versus this one.
Oh, you think so? I don't think mine's are lazy.
Okay.
Finally, I got to sleep. Man. 3 a.m.
She's like, she knows how to do it.
This doesn't count as smoking, it's a fucking battery.
Oh, you said you was going to.
No, that's how we're going to see it.
You see
it? I just want to see what the light looks like. I'm ready to use it. Yeah, I guess I didn't do that.
Yeah, I don't know.
That's good.
Like shit. I've said that 100 times.
Like shit.
Yeah.
Describe that. Alrighty guys, thanks for tuning in, Pop Squash. This has been an episode vlog 94. guys. Thanks for watching, liking, subscribing. I'll be right back at you again sometime, same place.